Microsoft Windows Server is one of the most in-demand technologies in the industry today. So in this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to install and configure Microsoft Windows Server 2025 from scratch. You'll learn important skills to help you further your career. By the end of the video, you'll be well on your way to building your very own Windows Server to administer. So if you're ready, let's get started. First thing we need to do is download a copy of Windows Server 2025 from the Microsoft Evaluation Center, and I'll leave the link for that below in the description. Now, I'm going to download the ISO file to install in VirtualBox, but we can also create installation media from an OSI file to install Windows Server on physical hardware too. Now, we'll be interested to know if you're planning to use a virtual or physical machine in your test lab, or if you just like to follow along with the video. Let me know in the comments section. So I'm going to click download the OSI file. And we need to fill in the registration details and click download now. Once you've completed your registration details and click download, you then need to select your Windows Server 2025 download. I'm going to choose English United States and ISO download 64-bit edition. Now do bear in mind the ISO file is a little over 5 GB in size, so it's going to take a little while and I'm going to just leave it to download. Before I begin installing Windows Server 2025, I need to quickly talk about system requirements. Now, it's not really realistic to provide a set of system requirements for a Windows Server because of the many roles a server can be deployed as and also the applications it may be running. For example, a file server will have a very different specification to a virtual host machine running something like Microsoft Hyper-V Server and multiple virtual machines. So one of the things that Microsoft suggests is to conduct test deployments to determine the specifications needed. Now, there are a set of minimum hardware requirements listed on the Microsoft website. However, do bear in mind, these are an absolute minimum, and a computer configured with an absolute minimum hardware specification is going to be slow. It's not something that I would use in the lab environment, and certainly not something that I would use in a production environment. However, there are some important system requirements we do need to be aware of with Windows Server 2025. And firstly, you'll need to make sure that the computer supports secure boot. Also, a trusted platform module, a TPM chip, is needed. If you don't have these, there is a workaround, but that's something that is really only suitable for the test lab. And finally, do bear in mind that the Windows Server 2025 ISO file is a little over 5 GB in size. So if you plan to install from physical media, you'll need to configure a bootable USB memory stick. And if you need some more help with that, please leave a comment below in the comments section. Here's a quick overview of the lab settings that I'm going to use for this video. I'm running VirtualBox and I've configured a virtual machine with the following. 6 GB of RAM, 2 CPUs, 105 GB of storage, a trusted platform module, TPM version 2, secure boot is enabled, and EFI is also enabled. Now, this is quite a low specification. However, it is only for the test lab, and it's not something that I would deploy in a production environment. I've also listed the IP address settings over on the right, and once we've installed Windows Server 2025, I'm then going to perform some initial configuration tasks so I can install server roles like Active Directory Domain Services later on. So if you're ready, let's begin the installation. I've started the virtual machine and I need to press any key to boot from the Windows Server 2025 OSI file. And this will get our installation underway. I need to choose the language and the time and currency format, which in my case is English United Kingdom. Need to select the keyboard. Now, if you've installed earlier versions of Windows Server, you'll notice the new look setup wizard. But there is an option down here on the left-hand corner to install using the older version if you prefer. But I'm going to stick with the new one. I'd like to install Windows Server, and I need to agree everything will be deleted, including my files, apps, and settings, if there was a previous installation there. And click Next. I now need to select the image to install, but it's important to understand the different options that we have here. Essentially, there are two editions of Windows Server. Windows Server Standard Edition, which is typically deployed in small to medium environments, and Windows Server Data Center Edition, which includes more advanced features for large-scale, high-demand environments. Now, we also have two options for each. The desktop experience includes a full graphical interface with menu-driven tools that we're used to seeing in Windows. It's the best option for running applications that require a GUI, and it's also more user-friendly. Now, the non-desktop experience option is known as Server Core. Server Core is a minimal installation and it does not include a full graphical interface. Instead, it's command line driven using Windows PowerShell. Now, I'm going to install Windows Server 2025 Standard Edition with desktop experience, which I'd also recommend for learning Windows Server. Now, if you reach the end of the installation and you're greeted with a black screen and a command prompt, it means you've installed Server Core by mistake. But don't worry, it's a fairly common problem and all you need to do is repeat the install. And as I often tell students, it just means you're gaining more practice installing Windows Server, which is actually a good thing. We need to review the license agreement, and if you agree, click Accept. I need to select where I'm going to install Windows Server. Now, if you don't see any disks here, it means you'll probably need to load a driver for a storage controller, typically a RAID controller. Now, we can see disk 0 is available with 105 gigabytes of unallocated space. But first, I'm going to partition the disk. This will create a dedicated area for the Windows Server operating system to keep it separate from user data and applications, depending on the role the server will have eventually. So I'm going to create a new partition, and I'm going to make it 100 gigabyte. Click Apply. Now, Windows Server Setup is going to automatically create some default partitions too, which are used by the operating system. And I just need to click Next. Okay, we're now ready to install Windows Server 2025 Standard Edition with desktop experience, and all data will be deleted. I just need to click Install. Now, this process is going to take a little while and the computer will need to reboot a few times. So I'm going to return to the installation when this is completed. I've rejoined the installation and now I need to set a password for the administrator account. And click Finish. Now we just need to wait while the setup is finalizing. So again, I'm going to skip ahead to save time. The installation is complete, so let's log in. Now the first login will take a little longer because Windows Server is creating a new user profile. Choose diagnostic data settings. I'm going to go with required only. When we log into Windows Server, Server Manager launches by default. We also have the option to try out Windows Admin Center and Azure Arc, but I'm going to skip that for now. And I'm also going to hide the welcome tile as well. Now, sometimes you may see some red tiles in Server Manager when you first log in, and this is typically due to network services configured to delayed start. Refreshing the dashboard a little later on usually resolves this. And if I click local server over here on the left, this is where we perform our initial configuration. So let's begin by configuring the server's Ethernet adapter IP address settings. Now, at the moment, the server is configured to automatically obtain an IP address from a DHCP server, which means its address can change. Now, it's important the server is assigned a permanent address that remains the same. Otherwise, client devices may struggle to find it and access services. So we just need to click the link and choose Ethernet properties. Now I'm going to be working with IP version 4 in this video. Choose properties. And I need to click use the following address to assign a static IP address, which is going to be 192.168.1.101. If we tab down, the class C default subnet mask is put in there automatically. I'm going to assign a default gateway, which is my router, 192.168.1.254. And I'm going to assign a DNS server. And click OK. I'm going to check my Windows server is activated. We just need to scroll across and we can see the evaluation copy there is activated. And I'm also going to configure the time zone. Yeah. The next thing I'm going to do is configure Windows Update. So I'm going to right click start and choose run and type sconfig. The reason I'm doing this is I prefer to manually install my updates. I need to choose option number 5, which is update setting. Number 3 for manual. And 15 to exit. I'm going to refresh the dashboard so that I can review my changes. This will take just a couple of seconds. Next, I'm going to configure the server's computer name, its host name, because as you can see, the one that it's been assigned by default isn't the most user-friendly. So we just need to click that, click change, and I'm going to give my server the name server 1. Click OK. Click OK again. And for this, we need to restart the server to take effect. The server's restarted. I've logged back in and I'm back in Server Manager. I'm going to go back to local server. And the next thing I want to do is install Windows updates, because even though this server is a server in the lab, updates are of course important not only for security but also reliability. So we're just going to click check for updates. Now this is going to take a little while, so I'm going to leave it running in the background. So we've successfully installed Windows Server 2025 and performed an initial configuration. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to take the server to the next level by installing and configuring Active Directory Domain Services. That's the cool technology that's at the heart of Windows Server. Now do let me know in the comments below what you think of Windows Server 2025. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, share it, and subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. So, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.